Hi guys, how are you? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing an actual talk through tutorial. You know how I feel about those. But it's a new year and why not have my first tutorial to be a talk through tutorial. I'm sorry if you don't like those, but yeah, I wanted to do it and my hair is completely straightened and it has no life to it. But anyway, I am going to show you how I use this awesome product from Milani. This is their new everyday eyeshadow collection, and this one is in the number 01 and it's called Must Have Neutral. This is an awesome palette. It's an awesome palette, and it's not only eyeshadows, but you also get a color that you can use as an eyeliner. And believe it or not, I actually did this wing eyeliner with this shadow. And I will tell you during the video, this color right here is a perfect highlight. But anyway, that's what I'm going to be using. And I'm also going to be using for the first time this Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color. And I think the name is in Seductive. I'm not too sure because they don't put the name on it and I can't remember what it's called. But I am using this for the first time and I'll let you know my thoughts on this as well. So if you want to know how I got this look, please go ahead and stay tuned. Thank you so much. Okay, so let's just start with the eyebrows. And I'm using today this eyebrow pencil from Lorac in the color Brunette. And it looks like so. And it's dual-ended, brush on one side and the pencil on the other, which I love, so you don't have to go tracking for an eyebrow spoolie. And this spoolie is pretty good. I like it. So I'm going to use this today. I haven't used it for a while. I mean, this brush is awesome to spread this product because this product is nice and creamy. And the brush is a little hard and I don't mind it because that way, oh, I hope that wasn't blurry. That way it can evenly distribute the product because it's a harder brush. So it's really getting into my eyebrow hairs. So like everything that is creamy, I am going to set. So I'm going to set with my all-time favorite eyebrow powder, which is from e.l.f. And this is, find the brush, this is the medium. Now we're gonna go ahead and put a base on my brush on my lids, and I like using this cream color here, and this is my all-time favorite dual eyeshadow from Jordana. I love this stuff. As you can see, hit pan big time, and I'm just going to put this on my eyelid. I have already concealer, so I don't need to put an eyeshadow primer because I use the concealer and that works just as well. And I am going to put some towards the bottom because I am going to smoke out my bottom lid. So, yeah, ugly. Let's get into the palette. I'm not going to use their tool. This doesn't really work for me. So I'm going to take this brush right here. And this is from Luxie, and I got this in an Ipsy bag before, and I am sorry, I used this fluffy brush, well, flat top little kabuki brush. I got this from eBay a long time ago. This brush, I love it for my transition color. I can't think today. So I'm going to use this color right here, which is a nice soft brown. And I'm going to put this up for my crease area. And I'm actually going to bring it in to my inner corner, because I want to actually contour my nose with this same color. I'm going to go do my outer area and somewhat in the crease, a fourth of the crease with this crease brush from Crown. It is their C441 Pro Blending Crease Brush. I love this brush. I'm going to use the darker brown right here. And let me tell you, go lightly on this because this one is really, really pigmented. And when I did this eye, I was like, whoa, I was not expecting all that. And it's very pigmented for being a matte shadow. So that's as far as I'm gonna go with this color on my crease. I'm not gonna go any further in, and I'm just going to blend it. So I'm going to take this concealer brush from Crown, which is C224, and I'm going to use it as my shadow brush. And I'm going to use this color right here in between the two that we already used. And grab my little mirror here. And we're going to just pat this on the lid, like so. It's a really, really pretty color. It's almost bronzy to me, which is really nice. Okay, so that is awesome. I love this color. I'm gonna go back with this brush that I used for my transition color with no product on it again and just blend the two, my outer V color with my lid color, just in this area, so there'll be no harsh lines, like so. So there, perfect. So now I'm going to clean off this brush. This little towel I have right here, use the same brush, go into the transition color, which is the lighter of the brown, and I'm going to actually contour my nose with this. I don't really like to contour my nose that much because my nose, come on, it's small as it is. But to balance it out, since I did bring it all the way into my inner corner right here, well, not corner, but my inner portion of my crease area, I'm going to bring it downward and around. And since this color isn't dark at all, I don't really need to blend it that much. So I'm just gonna use my finger, and there it is. Now we have a nice contoured nose. It's a perfect matte shadow to use as a liner. And what I did, I used this Seta eyeliner brush, which is really for gel, but I used it for that. So what you can do to actually grab this better is by just wetting your eyeliner brush with any setting spray and it will work. And I'm actually going to do this on film, and you know I don't put eyeliner on film, but it's so easy with this brush that I'm going to do it. I don't know that if is the brush that actually gave me this banging line or that the combination of the two did it, because this powder is awesome. I like it. So that was the most quickest eyeliner, winged eyeliner I've ever done to myself. Because even with my liquid liner, which I love, which I learned with a liquid liner, I've never done it that fast. So now I'm gonna take this dual-ended brush. I think it's from Crown. It is a Crown, and it is their C476 crease and shadow brush. I'm gonna take the actual pencil side of it and go to the darkest brown again. And we're going to smoke out our bottom lash line. Like so. And I'm not gonna go completely in because I am going to put a highlight in my inner corner. So at least to right here. Stopping before you get to your inner corner. And I flip the brush and I blend it more. So I don't know if this is getting fuzzy all the time and not focusing. I'll be really upset when I edit this if it is. But I'm going to take this small little Eco Tools, which it rubbed off, that's how long I have it now. And I'm going to take this right here, which is their base color. And trust me, it's too shimmery to be a base color unless you're looking for that shimmery effect, but it's really, really shimmery. And I think it's better off as a highlight than an actual base. So I'm going to put this in my inner corner. And I'm going to bring it up into my eyeshadow crease area on my lid. This trick right there will make your eyes pop open even more. And don't forget the bottom lash line, the inner corner portion. And there's your highlight. I always do this to blend it in. I'm going to go in with this brush again into the liner shadow, and I'm going to line my waterline with this. My look is complete. All I have to do now is just do my lashes, in which I'm going to curl first, like I always do. So I just put two coats of mascara and that is it. I'm not gonna put no lashes on. And yeah, I think it looks great like that, even without lashes. With my e.l.f. Professional Fan Brush, the small one right here. And I'm going to use the same eyeshadow that I use for my inner corner. And I'm gonna use this as my highlight today. So I'm gonna turn it this way so it'll be easier for me to grab with the fan. And I wanna highlight because I think this is a perfect, perfect highlight color. Look at that. I love this. I am in love with this as a highlight. I mean, who says you can't use an eyeshadow as a highlight? Because I know I do. I do. I'm gonna go down the bridge of my nose. It's such a subtle highlight, but it's a beautiful, beautiful color. I mean, they should have put this as a highlight and not a base because, seriously. Tell me you can't see that. This is an awesome highlight. So definitely, this should have been a highlight, not a base coat. So, before I forget, because I always seem to forget, I'm going to use this same brush that I use for my inner corner. Same inner corner highlight. And highlight my brow bone. Like so. So as for lips, I'm going to use this new Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color. And I think this is Seductive. I'm not too sure because they don't put the name of the color on the actual packaging, and I wish they would. This is a beautiful color. I'm gonna swatch it for you. I have not used it yet, but it's such a beautiful color. And I'm going to use it today because I think it'll be a perfect color to go with these neutral eyes. I can say this applicator is awesome. It is. So here's the finished look, and yeah, I actually am, one, in love with this color, in love with this formula, in love with this. So I'm definitely loving this formula. It's so smooth, it went on smoothly, and the applicator tip is actually great. I didn't have to use a lip liner to actually get my lips lined perfectly. And definitely this eyeshadow palette you must get. You're not only getting eyeshadows, but you're getting an eyeliner, and also, to me, like I said, a highlight. So if you like this video, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up. It does help my channel. And if you're not subscribed, please go ahead and hit that subscription button so you won't miss any of my beauty videos or even my plan with me videos. So I think I have nothing else to say besides I love you, and I will see you in my next video. Mwah! Bye-bye.